This morning's event reinforces to me that the Y is the place where community comes together to make a difference. Our collective impact could not be possible without your thoughtful generosity year after year after year. At our Y, cause meets community through our strong relationships and collaborations. And it's gratifying to see so many of our partners here this morning.
On January 29th, 2013, it was my turn to hear the worst news ever. You have a mass in your brainstem that is bleeding. I looked at my husband. I looked at our four-year-old son, Charlie. I thought about our six-year-old daughter, Ava, in kindergarten, and I felt numb with shock, disbelief, and anger. How could this be happening? I am a caregiver, not a patient. So believe it or not, our one stop before the emergency room was the YMCA. I needed to know Charlie was in a safe, nurturing place so I could begin to understand what I was facing. We were granted a scholarship for the kids to go to YMCA camp all summer. Amazing, generous, and very unexpected. We were thrilled. The kids were so excited when I told them. As a nurse, I had always heard patients' stories about how their community rallied around them in a time of crisis. Now, I have experienced firsthand the power of community and how it can ease a family's suffering greatly. It meant the world to us that the YMCA was willing to support our kids in camp. We wouldn't have been able to afford it since I haven't been able to work.
At the age of 3 months old, her mother and father, who were heroin addicted at the time, her mother had gone into a coma. And her dad had thrown himself in a methadone clinic and asked me to take care of the baby while he was in there. He was only in there 72 hours. He came out and said, "I need you to take full custody." I was so overwhelmed at the generosity that was offered to Autumn, where she could do all kinds of programs, and my granddaughter's face spoke for itself. Her eyes were huge, like she was at Disneyland. She saw the kids playing, and she wanted to be a part of this. Very badly. Autumn would not be as assertive as she is or have the confidence that she has. And she wouldn't be the funny little girl that she is, because that comes from being happy. And this is her happy place.
You know, the Y, they do a terrific job in everything that they do. Wednesday morning, you can find me in the pool with my 2.5-year-old daughter trying to teach her to kick and swim right now. It's terrific. And, you know, again, I think that I was put here to not just be a football player. Yeah, that's a little part of me that was given to me, a little part. God gave me a little bit to be a good football player, but to affect people's lives, help them, and be a great person. The biggest thing that I can do is help a 10-year-old kid with a dream that one day I can be a professional something. It may not be an athlete, it might be a lawyer, a doctor, something that they have a passion for. And I would tell them, yeah, do it, go for it. Put your heart and soul into it, because some things don't work out. Things in life are not fair. Some work out, some don't. But if you go after it and you put your heart and soul into it, whatever comes of it, you'll be a better person for it.
You all have the opportunity here today to make an incredible contribution to this cause, to this community, and to fuel what is, in my opinion, and I think it's shared by all those people who just raised their hand, that's why they're back here again and again and again, the most compassionate, empathetic, selfless, caring organization that this community is fortunate to have within its boundaries.
You see, the Y is a place where cause meets community, and all of you who are here this morning are a testament to the fact that our YMCA is also a place where community comes together, where we all belong, where we all benefit, and isn't that what community is all about? Caring for each other.
could build you a world, I'd start with the sky. I'd make it the color of your big blue eyes. If I could paint you a rose, I'd paint you out. Paint you out of this town. Right out of this town. Unbroken horses run wild and free. That's where you should be.
Thank you seems so inadequate when it comes to the life of a child. Your dollars have made a difference in many lives. And to say thank you, I feel, is never gonna be enough. So please keep giving so we can keep thanking you year after year for enriching the lives of all these children.